बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम अल्लाहुम्मा सल्लि अला मुहम्मदिन व आले मुहम्मद। वेलकम व्यूअर्स टू द लास्ट एपिसोड ऑफ एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप सीरीज। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू वाइंड अप द होल एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप सीरीज बाय एक्सप्लेनिंग द लास्ट एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डायमेंशन ऑफ एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप, दैट इज हाउ टू हार्वेस्ट एंड एंड अप द वेंचर और ए बिजनेस व्हिच इज गोइंग टूवर्ड्स फेलियर और बैंक्रप्सी। आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर द स्ट्रेटजीज टू हार्वेस्टिंग एंड एंडिंग द वेंचर, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द वीडियो। The success story of Brian Maxwell gives us many clues and insights to know about where to look for a possible success opportunities. Brian Maxwell, an internationally ranked marathon runner and coach at the University of California, Berkeley, was leading a marathon race in England when at the 21-mile mark he began to experience dizziness and tunnel vision, which forced him to quit the race. His consumption of energy drinks on the day of the race had failed and motivated him to find a solution for a better energy source. He teamed up with Jennifer Bidulph, a student studying nutrition and food science, and they began to quest for an energy bar that would taste good, be healthy and nutritious, and provide the appropriate ingredients to optimize performance. With approximately $50,000 gathered from savings, they were determined to find a solution. During 3 years of research, experts indicated to them that it would be impossible to produce a healthy product because of the large amount of saturated fats necessary for lubricating machinery in the food bar manufacturing process. However, after many failures, they found the solution. They understood that their efforts required developing a food bar manufacturing process that would not require adding fats for lubrication of machinery and would produce a product that would meet the desired attributes. The product needed to provide a balance of simple carbohydrates for quick energy, complex carbohydrates for long-lasting energy, and low fats for easy digestion. Hundreds of recipes were tested with athletes until the most effective and best tasting product was found. Continued requests among these athletes to have more of those power bars led them to final brand name, and in 1986 they officially formed the company Power Bar Incorporation. Initially, the company was operated from Brian basement. The first product which went on sale in 1987 were the Malnut and chocolate flavor. Their vision of finding a solution to serious runners' energy source was not the only factor informing the new venture. Both Brian and Jennifer were determined to create a work environment where employees would feel important and have a strong sense of pride in the company. Thus, they created a work environment where employees are called team members, the dress is casual, and the focus is on the sports. In the early part of 1990s, sales for the new venture increased by 50 to 60%. In 1997, sales began to slow and increased by only 23%. In 1995, Brian and Jennifer turned down an opportunity to purchase Balance Bar, a producer of an energy bar that targeted the more casual athletes and those who were looking for a nutritious snacks. They realized this was a mistake, that the venture could not survive on one product, especially when they saw sales begin to stall in 1995. At that time, there were many new competitors who recognized the opportunities in the larger markets by introducing energy bars for casual exercisers and snackers. So, in 1997, Brian and Jennifer began efforts to find new products. In 1998, they launched Power Bar Harvest, a crunchy textured energy bar available in a number of flavors that would target casual athletes and consumers looking for a nutritious snack. In 1999, a new creamy bar called Essentials and a new line of sports drinks were launched. Today, Power Bar is still the leader in the serious athlete market, and Harvest has just passed Clif Bar to become the number 3 brand in the category. Sales in 1999 reached up to $135 million. Company also opened a state-of-the-art manufacturing facility in Idaho and two distribution centers in Idaho and North California. It also established two subsidiaries in Canada and Germany as opportunities for sales growth in the international markets occurred. Brian still runs 40 to 50 miles per week. So we can see and learn from this success story experiences that important management decisions areas are reviewed and discussed in every step of the venture. Building a solid management team, a loyal employee base, and recognized by entrepreneurs like Brian as being very important during the early years, along with the financial and marketing control decisions. So viewers, we can see that even though the intent of all entrepreneurs is to establish a business for a long time, many problems can cause these plans to fail, since about one half of all the new ventures fail in their first 4 years of business. It is important for the entrepreneur to understand the options for either ending or salvaging a venture. This video deals with exit strategy that the entrepreneur will need to consider. These decisions can involve finding a successor to the venture, selling the business either totally or partially, or ending the venture because of bankruptcy. All of these likely scenarios are real and common among small businesses. Thus, to be prepared, the entrepreneur should understand each of these issues and be prepared with an exit plan before it is too late. One of the venture ending decisions that an entrepreneur may face is succession of the business. If the business is family owned, the entrepreneur would likely seek a family member to succeed. Other options, if no family member is available or interested, include transferring some or all of the business to an employee or outsider, or hiring an external person to manage the business. Direct sales of the business, employee stock options plans, and management buyouts are alternatives for the entrepreneur in selling the venture. These are all exit strategy options for the entrepreneur and need to be planned for early so that the crises are minimized. Bankruptcy offers three options for the entrepreneur. The venture will be reorganized under a plan approved by the court. With this plan, the entrepreneur strives to revitalize the financial conditions of the venture and return to the market with new strategies. An extended time payment plan to cover outstanding debts. This option is the debt must be exhausted before the entrepreneur is allowed to file liquidation. The court feels that individuals should be required to pay back some of their debts, and therefore this amendment makes it more difficult to file for liquidation. If the individual is unable to make extended payments, then liquidation either voluntarily or involuntarily is the final option. Keeping the business going is the primary intent of the entrepreneurs. Avoiding excessive optimism, preparing good marketing plan, making good cash projections, keeping familiar with the market, and being sensitive to stress points in the business can help keep the business operating. Entrepreneurs can also be sensitive to key warning signs of potential problems. Lax management of the finance, discounting to generate cash, loss of key personnel, lack of raw materials, non-payment of payroll taxes, demands of suppliers to be paid in cash, and increased customer complaints about service and product qualities are some of the key warning signs that a firm is headed for bankruptcy.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala Muhammad. Welcome viewers to the last episode of Entrepreneurship series. Today we are going to wind up the whole Entrepreneurship series by explaining the last and very important dimension of. Okay viewers, here I have end to the topic of today's video. So once again, I would like to request you all to please like, share and subscribe my videos and channel Spread the Light. As today I have a very beautiful quote for sharing with you. Once you choose hope, anything is possible. Life is too short to live, so never lose hope. Have faith in Almighty Allah. He definitely helps us in every way. Alright viewers,
I thank you so much for your support and watching my videos and supporting me throughout this journey of knowledge sharing. Here I am signing off from Entrepreneurship Series. Inshallah, I will come with some other new concepts and new knowledge contents to share with you. As I always say that sharing is caring. Till then, stay safe and stay blessed always. Thank you.